Right, Aki Karim, British Boxers, we're over here at Northside Boxing Gym today. It's, well, it was meant to be sparring day for you, Brad, today. Obviously, you're here with one of your coaches, Blaine Eunice. What happened? Just tell us a little bit about it. Sparring partner not turn up, so just...
Couldn't make it, my car broke down, so just did some pads instead, 8 rounds on the pad and a finisher, bit of bar bag.
I always find it interesting that fighters can go from gym to gym and just train. It's a good little community, really, isn't it, for that sort of thing?
Yeah, especially with me, like, you know, I've been around the amateur circuit for years, you know what I mean? So there's not many coaches around Manchester that I don't know, so...
You're about to say that don't know me, weren't you, but you changed.
Definitely not.
And Blaine, are you happy with what you're seeing from Brad in the gym at the minute?
Yeah, he's flying. We half expected him to be on an earlier date, a show that we were trying to get him on, so we was training for that anyway. Then that didn't come off, so it ended up August he was going to be fighting, so we had to bring his training back, and then we've ended up getting on the Ultimate Box undercard, which again's sooner. So he was fit anyway, so we've just ramped his training back up, so it's been perfect for us, really. We've managed it well.
And not only are you on the Ultimate Boxer undercard, you're in there with Alistair Warren, who we all know around the circuit is a very tough guy, can be a banana skin.
Yeah.
People usually wait a few more fights before they fight him.
Yeah.
You got in a bit early, so what's the crack?
Yeah, I feel like in the gym, everything's going well. In the fight, everything's going well, you know what I mean? I feel like I'm ready for this step up. I think at first when I turned over as well, like, we were happy to kind of hold the reins a little bit and take our time because of my age. But I think since Christmas, you know, in the gym, especially me and Blaine, really see the difference, so I think I'm ready for this now. It's what I want, you know what I mean? I don't want to be in there gym for the rest of my career, but I test myself, so.
Blaine, is he ready for it?
Yeah. Listen, I wouldn't have took it if he wasn't. I'm confident in him. Alistair Warren's a tough opponent. Like you say, everyone knows him. He can be a banana skin. But I think a lot of the time, there's a lot of fighters out there that, you know, you fight too many of these journeymen that are there to survive and that. And then when somebody does come and give it you, you don't know it. Do you know what I mean? Their ass falls out a little bit, or they're just not ready for it. Now, he's fought at the top level in the amateurs. I don't want him spending 2 years fighting people that he's, you know, in another league from. I want somebody to put it on him and keep him in live fights for now. Do you know what I mean? And obviously, I'm not going to chuck him in the deep end, like, in big fights straight away, but I want good tests for him. And Alistair's a good test for anyone. And I think on the night, you know, this is the kind of fight where you'll see how good Brad is. So, yeah, I'm happy with this fight.
Yeah, credit to you for taking it, you know, in terms of where you are at your career. And as I say, if you look good, then it will send out a message.
Yeah.
But, you know, Brad, how do you see the fight sort of playing out? Because Alistair Warren, he comes forward and he will come to fight, and he's not going to be... You might be in some uncomfortable positions at times.
Yeah, definitely, mate. And I'm sure you, a few times, like a couple of you, you'll see a big smile on my face. And, you know what I mean? He'll tell you, you know, I can box all day. Could probably use my jab, use my feet in that boxing, but if he wants to stand, have a bit of a tear up, you know what I mean? I'm more than happy to do that. Probably favourite, to be fair. But no, mate, I'm looking forward to it because I know it's the type of fight that I like being in, and the type of fight people will like to watch, so hopefully put on a bit of a show as well.
Are you sort of, correct me if I'm wrong, I'm just reading in between the lines, but are you sort of saying that you're sort of, you kind of almost want it to be an exciting fight? Is that really kind of what you're saying?
Don't stop, mate, yeah. Stand, phone booth. No, mate,
I do.
Yeah, we know what you do.
Game on out behind the window, he'll be throwing it in the corner.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Listen, you're saying there about he's going to be in uncomfortable positions.
Yeah. I say it could be uncomfortable.
Yeah, but... if you're going to go anywhere, you need to get comfortable with being uncomfortable. Do you know what I mean? It's going to happen at some point. Let's not spend too much time it not happening. Do you know what I mean? Let it happen now in fights that he's more than capable of winning, but that will ask these questions. It'll also show me what he has got in there as well. Because it is going to be tough times, and I'm going to see in the corner whether he's ready for them, because it's going to be tougher times out there. So it's, do you know what I mean? He's got to be beating his lads.
Would you like to see more fighters take step-ups earlier?
Yeah. I've always said it. I've spoke to you plenty of times. I think there's a lot of fighters out there blagging careers, mate. You know, I think that. There's a lot of fighters out there blagging careers, mate. And I'm not letting mine do it. He won't do that anyway, but I wouldn't let any of mine do it. No way.
So, yeah. And Brad, obviously, you know, the show being on the Ultimate Boxer as well, it's a good platform. It's,
yeah.
Obviously, you've had great platform on the VIP shows, which are all really good, and for the local area, it's brilliant. Steve does a great job with them. This one's going to go on BT Sport, though, isn't it, I believe? So that's an even, that's a big, big platform, that.
Definitely made us something a bit different as well, innit? Like we said, you know, I'm still learning and just, I want as many different kind of experiences as I can. My first day before weighing as well, something new. So we're going to have to work towards that. But yeah, it's a top show. Some good fights, even on the undercard, some good fights. So I'm really looking forward to it.
Blaine, if the fight goes to plan, you know, how you're planning it in your, I'm not going to ask you about game plans or anything, but if it goes to plan, now you've taken a little step up to, well, a decent step up to Alistair Warren, in fact. Where would you have to go next then?
Well, he's got two more dates before the end of the year. We've got September, November, and the original plan was them to be six rounders as well, another 2 6 rounders. So again, it doesn't have to be another big step up, do you know what I mean? We can hang around, get someone else, another tough journeyman, or we could take somebody that may be a bit of a step back, but it's a totally different style for him to work against, do you know what I mean? It's all just a learning process at the minute, innit? But we just want to fight different styles, different fighters, but again, we want to fight people that are testing. So it's not a case of now that we fought him, we have to do that. Do you know what I mean? We can hang around there for now. He's only young, he's still on six rounders, but we want to get the six rounders out of the way this year, and then next year we can start looking then, right? What do we want to do? What do we want to fight? Do you want to start picking them step ups? We've had a look at a few this year on the same bill on the Ultimate Boxer undercard. You've got Telford v Kilgannon. Friends with them all, spars with them all, but again, if they've got the central area and stuff like that next year, they're the kind of fights we want.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And they'd be easy to make because they're all VIP fighters and stuff, they're all Manchester lads. Steve's got a right good pack of middleweights there that next year he'll be in the mix with.
So should do like a middleweight tournament, shouldn't he?
VIP one.
Yeah, that'd be class, the VIP tournament. Got enough fighters on the roster.
Yeah,
class. And your stablemate Nathan Gorman's in a big fight as well coming up against Daniel Dubois. When it was first announced, a lot of people, I'd say, were picking Dubois to win by knockout. The further it seems to be getting nearer the fight, more people seem to be changing their mind and going with Nathan.
I think your more casual fans are the ones saying that, well, when the people that know boxing and obviously know Nathan, he's not really as well known as Dubois. I think they are definitely swaying towards Gorman because they know what he can do. But no, it'd be there's so many different ways the fight could go, that's why it's so interesting. But no, they're confident Nathan can get the job done anyway.
It looks like a lot of fighters from the gym now, Blaine, are sort of at that junction in their careers where they're being put into these tougher fights. You know, a lot of them are, and I know there's things coming like that for Joe Pickford as well, for example. But is that the sort of mood in the camp, in the gym at the minute? Just get the lads into the big fights now. Let's see the sink or swim situations.
Yeah, not so much big fights yet, but tests.
The tests, yeah.
Yeah, do you know that step up now? Let's fight somebody that's on your wavelength. Let's fight somebody that's unbeaten. The good thing is, we've got Nathan in the gym. Like you say, he's fighting Dubois, massive fight. And Nathan's never shied away from an opponent. He's unbeaten, he's fighting another unbeaten fighter. Joe Pickford's unbeaten, knocking people out. He's knocking on the door for titles. So it's good for these lads because we've got fighters in there that have already took that step, or they're taking that step now. And you know, they're going for it. So it shows these that's what you've got to do. And again, in our gym then, it'll become a thing of, you know, that's the progress. You get through these journeymen, you take that step. Whereas, if we didn't have them in, maybe we'd be happy to keep plodding them along for a couple of years. Whereas instead, we can see that you've got to start stepping in and fighting these other lads. We've got lads that are doing it in the gym, so it pulls the other lads with them. You know what I mean? So I think it all has a knock-on effect. And none of them would be shy of going for a fight then, because you've seen our gym, you're all on the scrap anyway. So,
yeah, I know.
So it's fine when that step up comes.
Fair enough. And Blaine, shut your ears. I've got to ask this question, mate, to Brad. I know you're not going to like this one, but Love Island.
Go on.
Your mate, Tommy.
Shut up, I don't know you, not mine.
Really? You put it on Twitter every 5 seconds. Oh, I know Tommy Fury. How's your assessment about how he's getting on? And don't pretend you don't watch it, please, as well.
That's it, called Love Island. What channel's that on? Nah, he's doing well, isn't he? He is. He's Yeah. Made for him, look at him.
I text him at 9:05, I get a text back at 10:05.
Telling you. Yeah, exactly.
Nah, in the house.
If you want to find him, he'll be on Twitter talking about Love Island.
In the house, he gets to about 5:02.
And in the group chat.
Love Island.
Oh, you're late, Connor will come out of his room and go, I've got a text! No, I'm going downstairs to watch Love Island.
I've heard John Fury might have to go in. There's a parents go in.
There is a parents thing, isn't there?
I'll watch that one.
We'll all watch that one. Class. Alright, so just to clarify the date, July the 19th, Altrincham Ice Arena. And open the boxer. Guys, get your tickets in. Come and see Brad. Is that how they get tickets to come see you?
Oh. Yeah.
Right. Yes.
Right, okay. Yeah, I've got
him all right, nice one, gents. Anything to add of you?
Yeah, Garmin's going to smash the bar. Yeah, right. 100%.
Definitely.
Fighting talk, I like it.
Round 9.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll agree with that.
Cheers, gents.
Nice one.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, leave your comments below. We love hearing your opinion, and also remember to hit that subscribe button. See you next time.